Welcome to the fourth and final of the pipeline routing exercises. In this exercise, we will show you how to use the virtual plane in navigation. The dimensions of this pipeline can be found on the provided sheet drawing. Let's start by adding a reducer. Start the route pipe command and place the cursor near the pressure connection point. Press Q to lock the cursor and press P to connect. Select the corresponding water system for your training area and select Pipeline 4. Press OK. A counter flange has automatically been created. In the right-click menu, select Add Components. Select Reducers, Concentric Reducers, and Size 125/80. Press OK to accept. The Z-coordinate of the next straight pipe segment can be defined by using TT. Press Z and type TT plus 2430. Press OK and left-click to accept the segment. The next segment is in the Y direction. Use the Routing Direction Assist function to lock the cursor in the right direction. By looking at the drawing sheet, you can see that the angled segment of this pipe is on the same plane as the angled segment of pipeline 3. This means that our next point is also located on this plane. In order to use this plane as a reference, we need to define a base point and the normal of that plane. To make things easier, use the view cube to go to the positive Z view. If we want to create a reference plane, we need to right-click, press Navigate, and press Go to Plane, Point and Normal. A simpler way to start this command is by pressing R. The cursor is now unlocked. Move the cursor towards the uppermost geometry point in this elbow and left-click. The first point of our reference plane has now been defined. We now need to define the normal of the plane, which defines its direction. The normal stands perpendicular to the plane. If we want the plane to be in the same direction as the angled pipe segment, we need to define the normal in a minus 45 degree angle. To do so, press S and type minus 45 for phi and 0 for beta. Press OK. As you can see, the next system point is now located in line with pipeline 3's angled segment. Left-click to accept. The next segment is in a 45 degree angle. This angle is an option in the directional routing assist function. To lock this direction, left-click the corresponding angle, then left-click far enough for an elbow to form. Now press U to undo the straight segment, leaving the elbow and locking the direction. We want to branch this segment into pipeline 1 from the Z direction. This means that the next system point should be exactly above the center line of pipeline 1. To do this, we'll use the Go to Plane, Point and Normal command one more time. Press R to start the command. Lock the cursor to the center line of pipeline 1 using Shift C. Left-click to accept the point on plane. The plane needs to be the vertical plane along pipeline 1. This means that the normal is the horizontal direction which is perpendicular to pipeline 1. In this case, that is the X direction. Right-click and select X-axis from the menu. Our system point is now located right above the center line of pipeline 1. Left-click to accept. From here, we can branch into pipeline 1. Use the direction assist to lock the cursor in a negative Z direction. Move the cursor near pipeline 1 and press T to select it for branching. Pipeline 1 is now highlighted. Press Enter to accept the branch. Press Enter again to accept the pipe. Pipeline 4 is now finished. This was the last of the pipeline routing exercises. Thank you for participating. Our entire curriculum can be found on the Academy website.